As the German front line was getting closer to the critical economic regions of the country, a huge effort was underway to curtail production and evacuate the major industries. Meanwhile, the situation at the front line remained grave. Despite the stubborn opposition of the Soviet forces, the enemy still maintained the initiative, and by November 20, 1941, Rostov-on-Don was almost completely occupied by the advancing German army. The German front line was getting close to the Rostomash territory, and time to complete the evacuation was running out.
The situation is bad. Having entered the town, the Germans are advancing towards the plant and we have no time to establish a defense. Workers are currently loading the freight train with valuable equipment and plant archives, and our main objective is to protect that train. We have established an ammo depot at a substation, and our reserves are already waiting there for a briefing. The enemy may attack us from these directions, but our forces are concentrated at the plant's key points. The 1st Regiment is in position by the coal storage facilities and booster station, so you shouldn't worry about your left flank. If the enemy attacks from the plant floor, they'll be faced with the squad in position by the maintenance facilities. The 2nd Regiment is in position at the plant office with a couple of guns. We can't predict how things will go, so you'll have to act according to circumstances. Let me give you some advice, though. Mine all approaches to the plant floor. This will at least delay the enemy. Mines are stored at the substation. We mustn't let them destroy or capture the train. We must hold them off until the loading is complete. After that, you must escort the train to Saratov. The motherland counts on you. Don't let us down, Junior Lieutenant.
Well, snipers and machine gunners are in position. Dispatch your men and reinforce the weak points in your defense. Remember, time is of the essence. The Germans are approaching. Use vehicles to tow guns to your positions. You will find munitions and mines in these crates. Lay mines in the expected directions of attack. And remember that the Germans mustn't get near the train. They will massacre the workers and we won't be able to complete the loading in time. That's all. Let's begin.
Да, командир! Слушаю, командир!
Да, командир!
They're already here! The Germans are near the boiler house!
Use the tank only as a last resort. This beast is the only one we've got. Use it, waste the ammo, left and right below the cone.
Soon, the main forces will arrive and things will get nasty. We have very little time to prepare.
Yeah,
Да, командир.
The Germans are near the factory workshops.
Слушаю, командир.
Building. The Germans are preparing another attack.
Oh!
The Germans have given us a small break, so we must use it to our advantage. Mind the approach paths to the train and plug the gaps in our defenses.
The Germans are near the factory workshops.
Come on. T-bone him.
Ah!
factory office. Hold on, lads.
Слушаю, командир.
The Germans have given us a small train. Let the gaps in our defense.
Поддержим огнем!
Немцы under fire!
Стреляем на счет 3-4!
The Germans are moving in on the factory facility!
Слушаю, командир!
Да, командир.
The Germans are moving in on the factory facilities! The Germans are moving in on the factory facilities!
Strong.
насчет три-четыре!
Workshops.
Germans were so close to reaching the train, yet we were able to stop them at the last minute. The workers labored so as to load the train, and it carried the priceless equipment away right under the nose of the advancing German army. Several months later, behind the Urals, in temporary sheds and in rooms without walls, the machines came to life again.
They were operated by 15-year-old boys, supervised by an old master. Their labor was a heroic deed in itself, but it wouldn't have been possible without this memorable battle, won by our soldiers amidst the smoking ruins of the Rostov factory.